This is Poet Bongani, and welcome to Zazise White.
A disciplinarian, as I can say, because as a poor family, she used to be a washerwoman, washing clothes for different whites in Bulawayo here, so that the family should subsist. Well, especially I wanted to be a musician. Yeah, against the will of my parents, of course. You know, people that time in the townships used to say that people who involve themselves with the music are sort of loafers and so forth. They don't see any future in that. My parents used to discourage us from doing music. But even then, I used to sneak out and attend some talent nights, shows, where I won about £5, I remember. Then I bought my mother a set of cups, a teapot, and so forth. They were very, very surprised that I could win such a prize. So I carried on singing.
Well, I'm Benny Pula Pulani. I born in Bulawayo. I like Bulawayo. I will die in Bulawayo too. I used to sing long time back. We started at Makokoba Township. It was long time, early 50s. That time we used to sing in the beer gardens,
you know,
with a plain guitar. At that time, we never even have a good instruments.
The story of the Krukunas begins in the streets and shapins of Bulawayo's oldest township, Makokoba. Almost half a century ago, in the early 1950s, where we meet young Timothy Sekani, who was the first to embrace music soon after leaving Mzilikazi Government School, where he had met the late Abiyeta Ruseke, the father of the Ruseke brothers, who was a teacher and a musician whose band was called the Boogie Woogie Songsters around 1951. Timothy Sekani joined the band with the likes of Steve Kadlula, Pascal Sibanda, Peter Kurete, and Phineas Tapona. When the Boogie Woogie Songsters faded, their next stop was the Reddington Mozambane's outfit, the Merrymakers, where they did not stay long. In 1953, Steve Kadlula initiated the idea of starting a group to Timothy Sekani, who is also cousin to Apple Sithole. Golden Rhythm Crooners was created. Ben Kumbo and Sunny Miller also joined the group. Dorothy Masuga, another veteran musician, would appear as a guest artist for the Golden Rhythm Crooners when they would perform at festivals and parties. The group reached its climax in 1953 when they were invited to perform during a Rhodes Centenary celebration held in Bulawayo alongside the Manhattan Brothers. The settlers were celebrating 100 years of colonizing Rhodesia. After the centenary celebrations, the Golden Rhythm Crooners toured the country and ended up in then Salisbury, now Harare, where they shared the stage with the Black Evening Follies. The late Safirio Mukadoda Matsikatire was there, singing solo guitarist. Unsuspecting 19-year-old Timothy Sekani kept the band's money in the pocket of his jacket. £75 raised from the shows. Dorothy and Steve stole the money and fled to South Africa, leaving Timothy and other band members stranded in the capital. Ben did not take the news well and accused Timothy of complicity, and the two fought over the issue. The group was able to find a place to stay while they tried to raise funds to go back to Bulawayo. Fortunately, at the same time, the late Sunny Zondo had split from Black Evening Follies and formed his own group, the City Quads. Knowing Timothy as a good bass guitarist, he invited him to come join them. Timothy Sekane played with the City Quads in Salisbury and was paid £5 and managed to send others to Bulawayo while he stayed behind playing with the City Quads. After the City Quads Umthali tour in Mutare, Timothy left and went to join others to settle debts the band had incurred. He then returned to Salisbury and secured employment. Meanwhile, Ben Kumboi had formed his own group, the Cool Four, when he returned from Salisbury. With him in the group were Lucky Todlana, Marco Mafumo, and Neva Nevada. A freelance pianist, Peter Jaffa, coined the name Cool Four. In 1955, Abel, who had just finished school, teamed up with George Matando, a goalkeeper from Umthali and Champion Banda, and revived the band Golden Rhythm Crooners. Later, George Chakasa, Andrew Chakawuya, Phineas Tapona, William Hlanga, and the late Simangaliso Thuthane joined the band, and once again the group became a hit. A year later, the group planned a tour into Congo, which did not go as planned as a result of logistical problems. Around that time, the war was at its early stages. Zambia was accommodating Black Rhodesians who went there as refugees. The people needed food, so the group played to fundraise for the support of the refugees. The news of their activities filtered through to the Sekler's regime, and they had to flee back into Zambia. In 1961, the group met Dorothy Masuka at Dar es Salaam. She introduced the band to Joseph Nyerere, President Julius Nyerere's young brother, who in turn took the group to ZAPU offices. At the time, the group also performed at the State House before the late President Nyerere and ZAPU leader, the late Joshua Nkomo. After the State House show, the group toured Uganda, Kenya, and many other African countries in 1962. Eventually, Abel, Timothy, and George opted to train as guerrillas, but George did not go to the front since he was playing with the Tanzanian band at the time. Abel was part of the recruitment arm of the struggle and was involved in fundraising activities. In an interview, Abel had this to say. The Organization of African Unity, now known as African Union, told us to fight for the liberation of our country. So I joined and went for training. I did my military service for a year and a half. At the same time, they asked me to leave the front line to go and collect funds to free Zimbabwe. I was captured. The judge condemned me to death, which was later changed to an 18-year prison sentence. Sithole was released at independence after serving 10 years of his sentence. After his release, he was asked to choose what he wanted to do. He opted to continue singing. I turned down an army job for music. Teaming up with some youngsters, we formed a group, the Newton Sounds. And when I left, I joined the Black Mansions. In 1982, I secured a job with the Makasa Rainbow Hotel in Victoria Falls as a cabaret artist. Lucky Todlana got detained as well in the company of Dumiso Dabengwa and then Matsimba Moto. In the year 1994, Abel Sithole went to Bulawayo and started the process of rounding up all musicians he knew from their time. This was under the Bulawayo Music Revival program. Abel managed to bring together an old-timer, Phineas Tapona, and two others who had grown up in the same suburb but never been part of the Golden Rhythm Crooners, Eric Juba and Robert Chirende. Timothy was still in Zambia after surviving a bombing in Tete, where he had been deployed. He did not return, even after independence, until his eldest son went to collect him. When he returned in 1992, he went into farming and never bothered to revive his musical career. Several attempts to lure him failed. George became the late Ndabaningi Sithole's bodyguard. He even stayed with him in exile in the USA. He is now late. Ben Kumbo also gathered former members of the Cool Four under the Bulawayo Music Revival program. But the efforts failed when some of the musicians demanded payment soon after their first show. Finally, in 1998, the old boys got together and the Cool Kunas were born, with Abel Sithole, Lucky Todlana, and Ben Kumbo as the members. Eric Juba was later invited to join the group.
Yo, my chance! Nega man, the cell phone!
Oh, nega chuba!
Siyami, man, nega Sithole!
Hai, bafowethu, nga Todlana le!
Hai, bo! Yini likakasa kanje, nga Kumbo!
In 1999, at a festival in Harare, the Cool Kunas saw an unexpected excitement of the public who acclaimed them. They told themselves that a second life was beginning for them and their music. In the year 2000, Jackie Kahi started working with the group as their manager, and a documentary titled Blue Sky was recorded under Pangolin Films. The documentary was a first directorial attempt by Patrick Munya, and it was co-produced by both Jackie Kahi and Patrick Munya. The group then went on to record an album in 2001 with the same title, Blue Sky, a 14-track masterpiece. The album was recorded in 2 weeks and the vocals in the same day. The album was such a success and it established the Cool Kunas as a force to be reckoned with. With hits such as Blue Sky, a song inspired by hardships Abel Sithole endured in a Rhodesian prison. Blue Sky is a terrible prison in South Africa with inhuman conditions during racial segregation. Blue Sky hid nothing but really high walls, no ceiling, no windows, no roof, no floor. The most dangerous murderers, political prisoners, and pickpocketers lurked there. Fewer came out alive from Blue Sky.
Sambamba.
Sambamba, Sambamba, is the same song to me.
The album also featured another hit song, Buluka Lami. The band went on to record their second album, Istalo, which was launched in France. On Istalo, the Cool Kunas incorporated the excellent vocal talents of Prudence Katomeni Mbofana to produce a rare work of art. Both albums were recorded under the Sony World Music label in France. In 2002, Ben Kumbo's health deteriorated such that he could not perform with the group and later passed away. Timothy Sekane was at last convinced to leave his plot and join the band. In 2006, Eric Juba, at 56 years, lost his life to a stroke. And later, the band was joined by George Salimu, Salimu, a musician in his own right, from as back as the 1970s, part of the disbanded Submarine Band, which he also led. Apples Tolo also passed away in the month of July in 2017 and was laid to rest. The group sang a rendition of its hit Bulekwe Lami over his grave to bid farewell to the third founding member of the group. In 2019, at the end of the year, the group lost yet another member, Timothy Sekane. The group has since recruited Michael Magwaza and Abraham Ngobe. One of the things that really stands out for me when it comes to the Cool Crooners is their performance. A couple years ago, I had the pleasure of watching them perform with their flashy colors and their matching outfits and their well-shined shoes and their polished choreography, how they moved so graceful on the stage. The group still continues to perform with new members, and they have said that they are working on a new album. And it's really sad that four members have passed without the group receiving any national award or Bulawayo award. The end. Well, fam, thank you for joining me on this week's episode of Zase Wide. I had so much fun learning about the Cool Crooners. I hope that you did too. If you are interested in knowing a couple of fun facts about the Cool Crooners, make sure that you do follow Zase Media on Instagram at Zase Media. And also, subscribe to the channel if you've not done so already, and like the video and share it with your friends and family. If there are artists that you'd like me to take a look at in future episodes, make sure that you do comment down on their names. Pride Bongani, signing out for Zase, Issue. Catch you on the next one.